In this video, I am going to explain how to solve single crystal, how to solve the crystal structure using OLX2 software. For solving crystal structure, we will be using WinGX software or else OLX2 software. These are the both softwares we can use to solve the crystal structure. In this video, I am using OLX2 software to solve the crystal structure. Then in my next video, I'll be giving you a demo using WinGX software also. In this video, let us solve a crystal structure using OLX2 software. Before solving the crystal structure, we should get the data from the single crystal XRT instrument. This is the data which we have got from the single crystal XRT instrument. We'll be taking small particle of the crystal and we'll be keeping in the single crystal XRT instrument. If we do like that, we can get the data like this from the system. We'll be taking this data. Using this data, we'll be extracting two files from this for solving the crystal structure. First file is .hkl file. Hkl file is a reflection file. And the next file is .ins file. .ins is instruction file. These two files I am copying in the another folder. I have separated those two files in the another folder. Using these two files, I am going to solve the crystal structure. And before solving that, we should have some expector structure in our mind. This is my expector structure which I am going to solve. I am thinking that I may get this type of crystal structure. This type of the structure. In these two nitrogens, one sulfur, one oxygen and three carbon atoms are there. Let us see the structure we can get or not using OLX2 software. Now I am opening OLX2 software. Software is being initialized here. Okay, this is the user interface of OLX2 software. Here, go to file and open the structure, open the INS file in this. We should not open HKL file here. We should open only INS file. Click on the INS file and you will get a screen like this. In this, what we do, just click on the work file. In the work file, just click the solve button. If you click the solve button, there will be a process going on. Solving, processing is going on. Afterwards, it will show some thick dots will show. Using the dots, we should expect there are some atoms are there. Now, the solving is going on. Okay, here you can see a little bit two molecules are, I think two dimeric molecules I have got here. But my expector structure is like that. I have expected only singlet will come, only a single molecule will come. But here, I think I may get a two dimeric molecule it is. So let me check again whether I will get a singlet or doublet again. I am clicking solve again. Let us see what we can get now. Solving is going on. The structure, all the atom have been scattered. So I am clicking solve again. Okay, here also I cannot able to find exact structure. So again I am clicking solve here. Solving process is going on. It will take some time. Here both the structures have come side by side. Okay, here you can see our expector structure is dimer only. We are not able to do anything. If it is dimer, we should solve in the form of dimer only. Here just open the expector structure. My expector structure is like this. And somewhere else I'll be getting one sulfur and one oxygen here. Okay, let us give the naming to the atoms. Okay, these here you can see this is very thickest is there. I think so. This will be the sulfur. Okay, so I am giving sulfur to this S1 and S2. Afterwards, I think the next thickness atoms are this one and this one. These are a little bit thicker compared to others. So I am giving nitrogen to them. Nitrogen to them. Click on the nitrogen here and consider this is N1 and N2. And next, this is N3 and this is N4. Afterwards, go to the expected structure. Here I have given nitrogens and one sulfur. I have given in between nitrogens and sulfur, carbon is here. Okay, here I think so. This will be the carbon. Next, go to the next half. Here carbon will be there. In between, I think so. This will be the carbon. And next, one side should be oxygen and the other side will be the CH3 molecule. So these Q3 is little bit thicker. I think so. This will be the oxygen. Okay. Here I am giving oxygen to that. I am naming oxygen to that. Click on to the oxygen here. I am clicking oxygen. I am selecting oxygen. Next, O2 is there. Next, how many atoms are remaining? 3 are remaining. I think so. All those 3 are the carbons only. C1 may be here. C2 and C3. Let us give the naming. I am selecting carbon here. After selecting carbon, clicking on to this. Okay, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6. Okay, now we have got some outline of our expected structure. Now we need to refine. Here I am refining this. Okay, just refine normally. After refining normally, we can able to have something, a picture like this. Now let us give hydrogen atoms. You can see an icon here, add hydrogen. So I'm adding hydrogen. Before adding hydrogen, we should give the ellipsoid. We should take the ellipsoid format. So I'm clicking on to this. It will be converted into the ellipsoid format. Afterwards, I am automatically giving hydrogen atom to that. Just click on to this, add hydrogen. Now you can see the structure. To this nitrogen, we have got 2 hydrogens. To this nitrogen also, we have got 2 nitrogen. And valency has been satisfied. Nitrogen will be having 3 bonds. And here in this nitrogen also, I have got 1 hydrogen here. And triple bond to the nitrogen. And this is the carbon atom. Carbon atom. Here for this carbon C double bond O, maybe this will be the C double bond O. Here we have got the ellipsoid structure. Here you can easily see the interactions between the hydrogen and oxygen also. To this interaction, we can see the distance between these interactions. O2 to H2 is 2.88 angstrom. We can name these also. That in my next video, I'll be telling you the distances also. We can name here distances and which type of bond, how much distance of interaction, all those things will also be explained in my next video. For this video, I'll be telling you only the crystal solvation. Here you can see maximum peak is green in color and minimum peak is green in color. GOF is also green in color. If there is a green in color in all, no problem, no need to refine and again. Here shift is 10.238. So we need to decrease this. This also should become in a green color. And one more thing we need to remember, that here R factor should be less than 0.005. As per the percentage, it should be less than 5%. We have got 4.43%, so no problem. These percentage indicates the impurities present in the molecule which we are going to solve the crystal structure. So here everything is fine. R factor also less than 5% we got, and here these peaks are also we have got a green in color, but here we can see a red color. This should be removed. So what we will do, we will refine again. So I am refining. It has decreased to 10 to 4. Again, if you refine, it may decrease a little bit. So still I have got 0.6 only. So refine it again. We need to refine number of time up to it should get a green in color. Then only we'll be getting 100% perfection. See, you can see yellow color. Maybe we can able to get the green in color. Okay, again refine again. Refine again up to till we can get a green color to the shifting. Refine again. Okay, now you got the all the green colors. So we have got the exact structure. We can save the, we can take the screenshot of it, or else we can extract this graphic also. We can able to extract from the tools. We'll be having some setting in this. We can extract this graphical structure also. Okay, I think so. I can understand. You've been able to understand how to solve the crystal structure. Here we have solved the crystal structure. After solving the crystal structure for the publication purpose, we need to extract this graphical structure, as well as we should have a zip file, .cif file. Let us see we have got the .zip file or not. Here you can see as it am I .zip file. This is the .zip file. You can see the properties of it, .cif. .cif means crystallographic information file. It can be viewed in Mercury software. It can be well visible in Mercury software. If you have installed a Mercury software in your system, you can able to open this and see the structure in that. Okay, this zip file will be used for the publication purpose. Then we should get the report of this. How can we get the report? Just click on the report here. There is some creating some report is going on here. We'll be getting some report in this. Automatically that file will be generated here in the form of a table, HTML table. Tables have been formed. This table should be given as a crystal data for the publication. I am just opening these tables here. You can see that. Okay, this is a crystal table. This table should be used as a XRD data table. This XRD data table, it should be used for the publication purpose. Here you can see almost all the details. Here you can see the empirical formula and formula weight, temperature, dry cleaning and phase group, and ABC values also you can see here, and alpha, beta, gamma values also you can see here, and volume also you can see here. Z value, everything will be seen here. Here you can see R1 should be 0.05. Here in this structure we have got 0.04, so no problem for us. If we get 0.05, more than 0.05, this structure should not be used for the, it cannot be used for the publication purpose. It should be 0.05. Here you can see all the patterns, and these are all the atoms, in between atoms, how much length is there, we can see here. This length will be in the form of a angstrom distance, and here you can see the angles also. There are two atoms angles given here, three atom angles given here. All the atoms we can use it for the publication purpose. Here if you use this software, we need to quote all these references. Without quoting these references, we should not use this software. We must and should use these references for publication. If you use this software for solving the crystal structure, we need to use these reference papers in our paper references. And all the crystal data is also given here in a simplified format. Okay, this is a crystal data. After this, let us go to the zip file. I am opening this zip file in the Mercury. We have installed Mercury software. You can open this using Mercury software. Now in the Mercury software, I'm opening this. Okay, here is the structure. This is the structure which I have opened in the Mercury software. Here I can able to see the packing also. We this is the packing of my molecule. Here you can see this is the unit cell. This is the unit cell, and these three red color and green color, blue color lines are there. These are the three accesses. You can see the structure also here. This is a single unit structure. If you want to draw the hydrogen bondings also, you can draw here. By clicking on to this hydrogen bond, you can able to get the hydrogen bonds also. You can able to extend the structure. If you click on to this, you can able to extend this. Here you can see I'm extending this like that. You can able to extend a little bit more, and you can use all these diagrams for the publication purpose. Okay, that's all for this video. Okay, if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel. In my next video, I'm going to solve the crystal structure using WinGX software. This is for today. Thank you.